As an experiment, I've been live coding on Twitch recently. And one of the coolest things about it is the engagement that you get when people can chat with you live. The problem I've run into, though, is that my text editor is always my primary window, so I can never actually see these chat messages coming through the Twitch screen. What would be really cool is if I could make a Twitch bot that sends the chat messages directly to my OS X notification center. So I'm going to show you how to do that and more on this Always Be Coding screencast. Hit it! Na, 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 na. So I'm going to create a new file called bot.rb, and then I'm going to open it in Atom. There's a little bit of configuration I have to do before I get started. First, I'm going to require the Ruby socket library. The socket library will let me open a TCP socket to talk to the Twitch chat over IRC. Next, I'm going to set two global variables, Twitch host, which is equal to irc.twitch.tv, and Twitch port, which is equal to 6667, which is the default IRC port. Then I'm going to make a new class called TwitchBot, and I'm going to set in the initializer four instance variables, nickname, password, channel, and socket. And that's pretty much all the configuration I'm going to need to do. The nickname is going to be the nickname that my bot has when it's in the chat room. I'm going to call it AlwaysBotCoding. Clever, right? The password is an OAuth token that's generated by Twitch itself. The easiest way to get one of these is to go to twitchapps.com/TMI. All you need to do is connect with your Twitch account, and it'll generate an OAuth token for you. Just copy and paste that into the instance variable. Next, at channel. This is going to be the channel of your Twitch account that you want your bot to be active in. My Twitch name is AlwaysBeCoding, so I can put my handle right there. And finally, for the socket, I'm going to do tcpsocket.open, and then I'm going to pass in the Twitch host and the Twitch port. And those four instance variables are pretty much all the configuration I need to do to get started. Now that we have an open socket into Twitch IRC, we can write to it whenever we want by doing @socket.puts and then some string. We're going to do this frequently, so I'm going to abstract this out into a helper method called defWriteToSystem, which takes a message, and this just does @socket.puts and then the message. Now, if you're not familiar with IRC, it's a protocol for communicating over the internet using plain text. It has its own syntax to it, which is pretty straightforward, but it might look a little weird if you're not familiar with it. But all that you need to know is in order to connect our Twitch bot into our channel so that we can write data to it, we're going to need to write four IRC commands. First, we're going to need to write pass, and then our password to authenticate our Twitch bot on Twitch. Then nick, @nickname, in order to register our nickname that we're using. Then we're going to need to do user nickname 0*nickname. Don't ask me what that does, because I actually have no idea what that syntax means, but you have to do this in order for your bot to authenticate properly. And then finally, you can join the channel by doing join #, and then the channel name. So these four IRC commands are what you need to do for your bot to actually join your channel. They're in my initialize function, so I'm never going to really need to worry about this. Just whenever I instantiate a new Twitch bot, it'll automatically connect to my channel. Now that finally, once my bot's in the channel, we need a way for it to write to the chat room. So I'm going to make a new helper called write to chat, which takes a message. And what this is going to do is use the write to system helper, but use the syntax privmsg, and then takes the channel name with the # in front of it. And this is going to take a colon and then the message. And this is the syntax for actually writing to a channel in IRC, but this will actually output the message into your chat logs. So this is all that we need for our bot to actually work and connect to Twitch. So let's test it out. Let me open up a Twitch chat room, and then let me open up my bot in the REPL. I'm using Pry, but you can use IRB. It should work just fine. And I'm going to make a new instance of the bot by doing bot equals twitchbot.new. And it looks like it's connected. And I should be able to do bot.writeToChat and then pass it a message. Hello world from a bot. hey, and look, it looks like AlwaysBotCoding wrote to our chat room. My bot's not going to be very useful unless it can read from the chat room also. So if you think about what I want this code to do, I want the Ruby process to park itself and listen for messages coming in from the chat room. When it gets a new message, I want it to process it and execute some sort of logic around it, then park itself again and listen for new messages coming in. The way I can do this in code is by making an instance method called run. Whenever I run my bot, I want it to park itself, and I'll do that by wrapping it inside this block until at socket.eof question mark do, and inside here I'll set a variable message equal to at socket.gets. Now I'm just going to put the message to the console for now so we can see what it looks like. So I'm going to go back to my console, and I'm going to open this with pry-r bot.rb, and I will do bot equals twitch bot.new, and I have my bot connected. Now I'm going to write to it from the UI and do this is a message. Well, actually, sorry, I have to run the bot first, so I'll do bot.run, and we'll see it logs some stuff. And now it's the thread is parked, and it's waiting for messages from the console. So I'll do this is a message from the twitch UI. And hit enter. And as you can see, this message came through, always be coding, exclamation, always be coding, priv message, channel always be coding, colon, this is a message from the Twitch UI. So now all I need to do is do some regular expression logic to parse this out and run specific commands around it. So I want to parse out the message and then send it to my OSX notification center. I can do that by running a logical expression, if message.match, and we only want to take out the actual messages using this priv message thing, not the commands that are run by the system. So we'll do colon channel, and this is the regular expression to just match the syntax of all the private messages that are being sent through this channel. And then we'll parse out the content by grabbing the first item of the match data, like that. And then we'll grab the username by doing message.match on at dot star dot TMI dot twitch dot TV, which is the way that I would get the username, and then grab the first item of match data there. So that should give me the content and the username. And then in order to write this to my notification center, we're going to need to use a piece of AppleScript. If you're not familiar with AppleScript, AppleScript is a scripting language that you can use to code your system on your Mac OS X. So in order to access the notification center, you need to use a piece of AppleScript. I'm going to make a command, and I'm going to use a here doc. And inside of it, I'm going to do osascript-e display notification content with title username. The script will look like that, and then I can shell that out to my system by doing system command. And I believe that this should work. So if I exit this, reload my bot, do bot equals twitchbot.new, bot.run, and then go back to my Twitch channel and write, this is a message from the Twitch UI, and hit enter. I see that this does pop up with the username in my notification center, which is what I want when my Twitch stream is in the background. So let's have some fun with this. If a user ever writes the word coffee in my chat room, I want the bot to respond with put that coffee down. So we can do a simple if matcher on content.include coffee. And if it does, we want to write to chat, put that coffee down. It's really that simple. So we can start up our bot. Bot is twitchbot.new, bot.run. Get the chat room open, and let's do, would you like some coffee? And we can see the bot immediately responds with put that coffee down. Now there's one more thing that's important to note here. Twitch will automatically disconnect your bot after something like 10 minutes of inactivity. Fortunately, they'll periodically send you these ping requests from tmi.twitch.tv every couple of minutes. If you want your bot to stay active indefinitely, all you need to do is respond to these ping requests with a pong command. I'll show you how that might work. In your code base, you could just do an if message.match on ping colon dot star, and if there is a ping command, then you can write to system with pong and then whatever came through in that match data, like that. Write the next command and hit end. And that will just respond to the pongs and then repark the thread so that it's listening on the chat log. If for whatever reason something goes wrong with your bot, it might be helpful to have a quit handler so that you can exit gracefully. I'm gonna make one more instance method called quit right now. First, I'm gonna write to the chat and say AlwaysBotCoding is out, just so people can know my bot has left. Then I'm gonna write to the system and run the part command on the channel that I wanna leave. This will let my bot exit the channel. And then I can write to the system again with the quit command, which will exit the Twitch IRC. And then if anything goes wrong, I can delegate out to that quit function. One of the great things about these simple scripts is that you don't really need to worry about deploying them. You can just kind of run them locally whenever you're online streaming. I'll show you a couple lines I would add to set this up. First, I'll instantiate the Twitch bot in my actual code base so I can just run this as a script. I'll put a trap command around the INT message that just wraps my bot.quit, so if anything goes wrong, my bot will exit out gracefully. And then I'll call bot.run, so the bot runs by default. So let's go back to our console, and instead of doing pry-r, I'll just do ruby.bot/rb, and now my bot's running. I should see it in here if I want a coffee. My bot says put the coffee down, it shells out, and if I quit out of my bot, I'll see the AlwaysBotCoding is out. So yeah, that's all that you need to do to make a bot on Twitch. As always, I am at AlwaysBotCoding on Twitter. Get in touch if you've got some comments about these videos that I've been making or have suggestions for topics that you want me to cover. I've got some big content coming up this week about coding smart contracts for Ethereum. I'm really excited about that. Until then, peace.